It's that time again. Save money now and buy these Nintendo Switch games before it's too late. I have years of experience buying games at the end of past console generations for cheap prices. And now some of them are worth hundreds, if not thousands. So I've spent hours going through the full Switch catalog to let you know which games I feel will go up in value and the reasons why. Stick around until near the end of the video, as I've included a bonus item that isn't quite a game, but it's something you need to act on now and collect while the time is right. I want to thank everyone that watched the previous video in the series. Your support means a lot. We're building a great community, and I can't thank you all enough. Okay, let's get to the games. The first game that we have up today is Shantae, Half Genie Hero. We've talked about Shantae in some other videos, and we know the prices on these ones are always going to remain high, if not get even higher in the future. This one came with two different editions here in European regions. There was a standard edition, and there was also a kind of bigger boxed edition with a few extra goodies in there, so look out for that one because it's nice to have on the shelf if you can get it. This will go excellently paired with all of the rest of the limited run games in the Shantae series, and having all of those on the one system is something that people will be looking out for. So it's worth adding this one to your collection if you'd enjoyed some games in the series previously, or even as your first Shantae game. I think it's a good stepping on point. These in general are just great games, you should have a lot of fun, consider picking it up. The second game today is Kowloon High School Chronicles. This caught my eye recently and I actually picked it up in the last few weeks. The great thing about this one is, and I do like to point this out from time to time, this is a really good deal currently. You can easily pick this one up for under $20, £20, €20. I think I got it for around £15. And it's a Japanese dungeon crawler, kind of like a role-playing dungeon crawler. It takes place in the first-person perspective, and you play a high school kid. In that sense, it did kind of remind me of the Persona series. So you'll be attending a modern Japanese high school, and then away from that, you'll be exploring these kind of ancient Egyptian dungeons with your friends. As I said, it takes place in the first-person perspective. If you're into those kind of old school dungeon crawlers or the Etrian Odyssey series, this one is really interesting, and as I say, it is cheap at the moment. But the reason it attracted my eye was because a lot of reviewers have said this one is a little bit of a hidden gem, or that they did like it or enjoy it, and I thought, look, I'll give it a try. And I really enjoyed it as well. So if critically it's done decent and it's a very low price at the minute, look, you've got something that may go up in the future. And even if it doesn't, you've got yourself a nice little game to play in the meantime for a cheap price. Unraveled 2. So Unraveled 2 is on this list probably because it would have had a lower print run. This came from EA, and it was around the time EA were trying to diversify out and have a few different types of experiences. So instead of their standard kind of sports games and maybe bigger action type games like the Star Wars titles they do, they were trying to get in bed with smaller game developers and do more kind of indie style of titles, and Unraveled and Unraveled 2 were two of the most successful ones. The first Unravel title in the series, it was a single player platforming game, and it did have some really unique kind of charm and characteristics. The second one takes on a slightly different tact though. This one is more multiplayer focused, so you are able to play the entire experience here co-op. So it is a nice little family game if you've got another gamer in the household that wants to play. It's a fun platformer to play along with them. And it's relatively short as well, so it's one that you can get through quite easily. But it does have a lot of charm, a lot of neat little gameplay factors, especially with the co-op element in there, and this one is a great title to check out regardless of price. The reason why I think it will go up the way though is due to the low print run. This came to Switch a good bit later than it was on other systems, and I don't think it done particularly well in terms of sales. It did review positively though, but the print numbers probably weren't there. So definitely have a look into this one, especially if you're hankering for some co-op gameplay. Phar Lap is the next game on today's list. This one is a little bit left field for me. It's not normally something I'm into, but if you're a fan of this style of game, this is definitely one for you. And if you're a fan of just collecting and looking at kind of rare titles that may or may not go up in the future, this is another great one to take a look at. So Phar Lap is a horse racing kind of simulator game. So obviously you have sports titles like FIFA or EA FC, as it's now known, for football, or you have NBA games, NHL games, etc. But horse racing games are something that I've never really been on the lookout for. But looking into this one, it actually is receiving kind of positive praise from fans of horse racing. It's reviewed really well, and I've seen some people saying this is the kind of horse racing simulator to look out for. In terms of what I'm looking at it for, which is really just to see in terms of the game's value and collectability, it does look like this one is going to be relatively collectible. There is a niche fan base for this, and they'll want to grab it and pick it up. But it's obviously got low print run, as it doesn't have that kind of mass market appeal. At various points of this game's life, it has been far higher in price because there haven't been many copies around. But if you look hard, you can still pick up a copy of this for relatively cheap. I had a quick scan over eBay and there are some available at good prices. But the fact that we have at times seeing it fluctuate up in value does lead me to believe that this one may be hard to get in the future. It's reviewed relatively well. If you're into that type of game, it's definitely one for you, and even not on the casual side, it is a bit of fun to play around with. Brain Training. So this one had a little bit of controversy when it came out in terms of the physical edition of the game, and I know a lot of people that watch this are from the North American regions, and that is where the controversy sprang from. This game didn't receive a physical release in North America, and I remember thinking that was really strange at the time, but with the Switch being region free, you can pick up a copy from the regions it did come out in. So I believe the game came out in Japan, but it definitely came out in Europe where I am from, and that means you can get an English copy of the game with the box art and everything in English ready to go. The reason I think this will go up in the future is due to its limited availability, obviously. It's only came out in those two regions, which means collectors from North America that are fans of the series will want to pick it up. It's obviously a Nintendo published game, which tends to mean that it'll hold its value, as we all know. And the Brain Training series is actually a really cool game. I do enjoy from time to time popping this one on and testing myself out to see how much dumber I've actually got. Something to look out for with this one is when it first released, I don't think this is currently available on the later copies, but when it first came out, it did come with an exclusive stylus for the Nintendo Switch that came inside the box. If you're looking to pick this one up on eBay or something, or you're importing it for an American audience, it's worth trying to get one with that stylus because, again, that'll just add to its rare ability later on down the line. Next up, we've got a couple of super rare games. So the first one is Shelter Generations, and yeah, it's published by Super Rare Games here in the UK, and this one I actually picked up a good while ago for a half decent price, but it has skyrocketed since, and that has led to the game being well over kind of £100 or so. And with it coming from a limited print company, we know that's just going to make prices skyrocket in the future because there's going to be so few copies of this game. You've also got collectors that will want to have the entire Super Rare Games catalog and every one of their numbered releases, which this is part of. So as time goes on, less and less of these are going to be available to snap up because they'll be sitting on collector's shelves. As for the game itself, if you think it looks fun and you don't want to shell out £100, you can pick this one up on the eShop for relatively cheap. It does go on sale. I think it may actually currently be on sale when this video releases, and it's a fun little experience, smaller type of indie game, quite simple, but effective in its own way. Is it worth paying £100 for? In terms of the gameplay, I don't think so. But in terms of the collectability, it's definitely something to keep an eye out if it's something you're interested in. And I did say that we would have a double helping of super rare published games, so the next one up is The Flame in the Flood. This is one of their earlier games, I believe this was the second title that they actually released, and it's fluctuated up and down over time, but it's settled on a reasonable price point at the moment. I think you can pick this one up for around £50 or so if you're looking in the right places online. If you're in Europe, CEX has this game for a really good price, and you can obviously hunt around eBay or other secondhand stores. This is a roguelike survival game, and it's got a lot of praise over its lifetime, so it has been out for a few years now, I think it's 5 or 6 years that it's been out, but the gameplay has been praised on this one quite a bit. And it started off, I think, originally as a Kickstarter title, and it got a lot of praise and hype from that, where it met its goal and then was able to be made. In terms of the Switch version, this is the complete edition of the game, and as I said, published by a limited publisher, so there are only so many copies of this one out there. Again, it's one that you can import to the North American regions, cover and everything like that is in English, and it's a neat little experience that I think, if you're into roguelikes, kind of survival type of games, this is a great one to pick up. Okay, so final thing to talk about is our bonus item, and I like this to be a physical item that's usually not an actual game itself, and today I'm going to be talking about limited edition docks. So one of the coolest things for the Switch, and one thing from the very start of the system that I wanted, was different types of dock. And if you remember back to the very start in 2017 when this thing hit, there was a kind of aftermarket for sellers selling on dock socks, and it was a sock that you would have put over the front of your dock to change the kind of style of it and hopefully protect your screen, because some of them were picking up scratches on the Switch screen. So the dock socks are an option, but luckily Nintendo has come through with a few different special editions over the years, and they're definitely worth picking up now, because I believe in the future these will start to raise quite high in price. I personally have picked up the one for Splatoon that came out. I thought it was really cool and unique with those ink splatters and everything. Splatoon's just a series that I absolutely love, so having that one is really cool for me. Another couple of my favorites, I do have the one for Zelda, that white and gold. I think it was really effective, really well done, and I think it's beautiful with the OLED Switch inside it. It works really nicely with the Joy-Con that came with it, but even if you don't have those special edition Joy-Con and you can just pick up the dock on its own, if you like it, it's something to think about doing now before they start to get really hard to come by. The final one I'd like to talk about is the Mario red one, and on the back of it, you can unclip the back and look into obviously where you plug in the power cable and everything, and in there you're going to have hidden little coins. I think this was such a nice little detail, and it's definitely one that I'm going to be on the lookout to pick up in the future. I want to thank you all very much for watching. The series has finally reached double digits with number 10. Number 11 will be along sooner rather than later, and I'll see you guys in the next one.